No, your conditions are really great.
Oh, thanks a lot, man.
Thanks a lot.
Hey, what's going on?
What's the difference on the hot dogs?
I don't know what the difference is. It's all Frank's. If you really want a difference, try the Kanish.
Can I get a Kanish, please, and a Coke?
Hey, got you covered.
No, I'd like one of the dogs.
Well, this one's the Frank. Over here, you got the sausages. And these ones here on the end, well, they're 15 cent extra.
Meat better?
Meat's meat.
I'll have the expensive ones.
It's your funeral, man.
I'll have another Kanish.
Oh, absolutely. I got you.
Is there any charge on that?
Man, no charge on the mustard. Mustard's free, man. This is New York.
Didn't give me plenty.
I get a Kanish.
Kanish with a Coke, please.
Some of this?
Yes, please.
Here you go. Something to drink.
Nah, it's
good. That'll be $2, sir. Thanks. Who's next? Hey, you take one of those. Hey, man, what's going
good,
on?
How you doing?
All right.
Man, let me have a Kanish.
All right. Oh. Is something wrong? Something to drink? Large or small?
I don't care.
Here. That'll be $2, sir.
Thank you.
Next, please.
Yeah, and a Kanish over here.
Vietnam vet, homeless, HIV, I got nothing. Even if you got nothing, you got more than me. Vietnam vet, HIV, homeless, I live in a shelter. Can't even rob. Can't even be a criminal and hold you up the way I should. Huh? Come on. Think I like this? Huh? Begging? just trying to stay alive.
Come on. Hey, sorry if I offend you. Sorry if I'm not beautiful. Sorry I'm not Richard fucking Gere over here.
Ow! Hey! Watch where you're going. You ruined my shoes.
Keep your shoes out of the way.
Don't tell me to keep my shoes out of the way.
Then don't complain.
Look, you ruined my new shoes with your fucking tread marks.
I don't give a shit.
Do you know how much these shoes cost? Do you know how long I worked to get these shoes?
I don't have a foot.
Aw, so you don't got eyes?
So you're a piece of garbage.
Ow! You fucking creep! I can see you got what you deserve, you derelict.
Give me my cup.
No!
Give me my cup. I'm a Vietnam vet, for Christ's sake. Give me my cup.
Oh, when were you in Vietnam? When you were
73,
I was there.
Give me the fucking cup.
You're a fucking liar and you ruined my shoes.
Give him his money.
No.
Give me my fucking cup.
Fucking hands off me.
Give me my cup.
You ruined my shoes. This guy is a junkie and a fake. Is that even your leg? You got another real leg hidden under your fanny, huh? Oh, does that hurt?
Ow.
Ow.
Give me my cup.
Give me the cup. Okay. Want the cup? Okay. Come on. Come on.
Give me my fucking cup.
The sight of you makes everybody in this car vomit.
Give me my fucking cup.
Give me my fucking cup.
Give it to me!
Okay. Take your cup. Get your fucking hands off me. Am I right? Am I right? So they can't talk their mouth until full of vomit.
Stop it. She's got my money. What am I gonna do now?
Don't give him any money. They do this together. I saw them before. This is a scam. I seen him on the number 2 train. Do not give him any money.
What are you
doing?
What's wrong with you? What are you, sick? What's wrong with her?
Yeah, how old are you?
You don't look old enough.
Yo, are you really in the war?
Yeah.
Excuse me. You saw those people before? You never saw them before.
The government provides adequate services to shelter people in that condition. Churches and hospitals, supported by private donations, will be better equipped
to... You made that up. Why the hell did you... Why did you make that up?
If you don't leave me alone, I'm gonna start screaming.
No, why the hell did you make that up? I don't...
Look, please, just leave me alone.
I don't got no family. I don't
want to
do crack no
more. She made that up.
Help the homeless. Brand new issue, hot off the presses. Homeless news. Help the homeless. Brand new issue, hot off the presses. Homeless news. Help the homeless. Brand new issue, hot off the presses. Homeless news.
Fascinating story in here about Princess Di. That she might be palaceless. She's showing homeless.
The following is a true story. I take the 524 train into the city every morning.
Mind if I take the paper?
Mind if I take the paper?
takeover of Grovercon torpedoed last night. Check it out.
We're adding QAL to the S&P tomorrow. Check your position.
Watch the closing doors.
How'd you know?
Hutton. Pardon?
Layman.
What?
Smith Bonnie.
Oh, you mean?
Your job. Goldman Sachs?
Where I work?
Your trade, yes?
Yes.
It's Cordell Sleevec, of course.
Yes.
It's fine.
Yes.
Solid.
Yeah, I'd say.
Small.
Well.
Not your fault.
No. QAL, how did you know?
Your stuff.
Oh, yeah.
The paper.
Oh. Money is the price of life. Money is the price of life. Ralph Waldo Emerson. You think he's right?
I don't really know.
Let me tell you a story. A couple of years ago, I'm in big on a trade. Not on my own, mind you. I got company. My partners and I, we have what you call information. One of my partners, this was his first big trade. He was a $10, $15 guy at best. Now was a different story. Don't get me wrong. This fellow had money. Money was not the problem. The problem was he didn't have it. Here. Do you have it here?
Me? Well, I mean, I don't know.
You have it. Don't sell yourself short. You have it. You do. It's written all over you. But this fellow, this man of whom I'm speaking, for him the jot was just too big. He fell apart. I'm not exaggerating. He fell apart with worry. Stopped sleeping. Stopped eating. A few weeks later, he was dead as dirt. The irony is, this is really tragic. A few weeks later, we all get out with a 6-point bump. Money in the deepest sense of the word. But for him, money was the price of life. Will you take it?
What?
The paper. You haven't read it.
Oh, no. You can have it. Here. You were a traitor.
Not by profession.
Oh, well, with your skills, you could have a job at any house.
As the hooker once said, if they pay you for it, it's not love.
Yeah. Take a look at copper cathodes. It's traded London metal.
Cathodes, nothing big, small position, huh? Fly, 10.
Good for you.
How long?
Long?
The copper to hold it.
How long, of course, is the crux. You're a cautious man.
Yes, I suppose.
man who lives within his means suffers from a lack of imagination. Do you believe that?
You mean me?
Let me show you something. My portfolio.
Oh, no, I don't think I should.
No, please, take a look. Come on.
Oh, these positions are
large.
Yeah.
You're amazed. A man like me. You are. I can see it in your eyes. What about the risk?
Well, that depends on your circumstances.
Nicely put.
The copper.
Don't worry about the copper, Jonathan. I put you in and I'll take you out. When the time is right.
Wait, how'd you know my name?
Don't miss your stop.
When I got on the train the next morning, the man was waiting for me.
Good morning. We have something to talk about.
What?
The Rand Pharmaceuticals.
Yeah, I know the firm. It's privately held.
Suppose I tell you I know a man.
Yep.
A man with a piece of it, the company.
Yeah?
What's it worth, a piece of Duran going public as it is?
Serious money.
Enough to make you cry.
Sit down.
This is the thing. This is the beauty part. This man has debts, sizable debts, debts that must be collected before the public offering. Follow me, Jonathan? This man, his position is worthless to him. Cash is what he needs.
Stock. It's a potential. He could use it for a loan.
He cannot. Because of the nature of the debt, the nature of the people he owes this money to, he must repay these people and quickly before his situation is discovered. You see? This is where my partners and I come in. We have been offered a piece of his piece.
How much?
$300,000. We have two in hand. There's more on paper, but we have decided to open up our circle, bring in other men, younger men, men with ambition.
Me?
For one.
Yeah, how much?
Piece of our piece. Not large. Beginner stuff.
Yeah, how much?
Almost nothing. 20.
I have $20,000.
You have 10 in the copper. Take a loan against it. That way it's only another 10 out of pocket. You, a man like you can always get his hands on 10.
Who are the other partners?
These deals are based on the silence of friends. The lesson of Ivan Bosky, what you don't know can't hurt others. I myself am acquainted with only three of the other partners.
Man, looking for opportunity. Not on the subway.
Opportunity, by definition, is happenstantial. If you only seize what's obvious, you'll never be rich. Carpe diem, Jonathan. If you don't, you'll hate yourself in the morning.
I have to think about it.
You'll find yourself checking the Quadron, looking for Duran, watching what should have been your future, slipping away from you.
I have to think.
Balls is what is required here. What is required here is to be a man.
Check.
Cash on the line. Check can be traced back to you.
Yeah, of course.
Tomorrow morning.
I didn't get on the train that morning, and I never saw the man again on 524. I thought about him, though, about whether I had narrowly missed being conned, or maybe I had turned my back on the biggest opportunity of my life. In the months that followed, I couldn't stop thinking about why the man had chosen me. Did I look so vulnerable, or did I have a weakness in my character so evident that it attracted the man to me? Even now, I cannot say. He was right about one thing, though. Duran Pharmaceuticals did go public, and I did check the Quotron for it every single week. By the end of the year, it was up 20 points. About a year later, I caught a later train than usual.
One street, four street. Change here for the number two.
Mind if I take the paper?
Craft Integrals is talking merger. Check it out. Hutton, Lehman, Smith, Barney, Goldman Sachs. You trade, yeah? Next
stop. Hi, it's Fern.
I know.
Yeah, well, I'm on my way.
No, I'm taking the subway.
What? Everybody in New York does it. I'm not a wuss. Got everything I need, believe me. Directions? Yes, I know. Take the number 6 and then change trains. I got it. All right, I'm on my way. Bye. Thank you. My perfume. Excuse me?
You want to get off the next stop.
Okay, thank you. I know exactly where I'm going, but thanks. I wouldn't not know where I'm going.
I'll never leave you in the kennel again.
Look, you know you're not supposed to sleep here, right?
What?
Come on, please. Go.
They're going to shut down the daycare center that Michaela goes to.
Right.
Now Lisa's going to have to take Michaela to work. How long is that going to last before they fire her? Please.
Right.
You see, that's Republican politics, Jake. I still cannot believe you voted for him. I can't believe that. Jake, are you listening?
I'm listening.
How can you justify voting for a man like that? I don't understand.
What?
Were you not listening to me?
I'm listening. I got distracted by that lady's hat. Look, check it out. It's crazy, right?
What did I say, Jake?
You're talking about the mayor. I heard every word you said. I didn't hear everything.
Is it that you don't respect my opinions?
It's not like you're teaming with revolutionary ideas. I'm joking.
All right.
I'm just playing. That was a joke, Belinda. I'm just joking. Where are you going?
Jake, we don't listen to each other. We're not with each
Belinda.
Other.
Huh? I'm listening to everything you said. I heard the mayor. I'm listening. I'm with you. Belinda. Where are you going? Miss, are those flowers real? They are?
I think the Democrats are ruining this country. They don't really care about the poor. They don't care about the elderly. They certainly don't care about the mentally ill. They've had plenty of chance, and things just keep getting worse. Don't you think so?
I think that the Republicans are much worse than the Democrats. I think that the
Democrats are a lot more sympathetic than the Republicans. The Republicans, they don't really care. They don't listen to what the people want. They don't care, and that's why things keep getting worse.
Things are worse than ever.
I don't know what's going on. We're just not, my boyfriend and I, we're not connecting, you know, we're not, you gotta be with each other at some kind of basic level, and I don't think that we are. I don't think that he doesn't love me as much as I love him.
Things are worse than ever.
I do want it to work. I do. Fuck. Damn. Are you married? This is my stop. It was nice talking to you. Thanks for listening.
I'm really sorry about my socks today. They're down.
Ruining the country. They've had many chances and they do nothing. I mean,
they don't care about the workers. They don't care
about the. What are you talking to that man about? I got you something. I had to buy the whole hat. I love you.
I must have ridden the cyclone 19 times waiting for my girlfriend to show up. She never did. But none of those rides comes close to the ride I took after I left Coney Island. It started when I found out why Jean never showed up. Her boyfriend and some of his buddies explained it to me. Ex-girlfriend, split lip. I figured the ride was over. Boy, was I wrong.
You sure, kid? Pretty bloody. Sorry. Never nurse a man you don't know. I read that in Dear Abby yesterday. I actually did. I read it in Dear Abby. I'm Layla.
Layla. I'm Wayne.
Wayne. Okay. I'm sorry. Here, put these on. Cover your bruises. Where are you going?
Penn Station.
Yeah? You have to connect to J Street.
That's right.
Look, Wayne, Knowing how to connect down here is the whole deal. For instance, you should be on the first call.
Really?
Come on.
She wrote me, actually. Wrote I should meet her today. My brothers were coming in for the Yankee game. My mom doesn't want me seeing her, so I told her I was going with them. Guess she didn't want to see me either. Looked all over for her. No Jean. Bad luck. Maybe.
You know what I like about the subway? It's underground. It's like there's a whole different world down here. You have to descend to get into it. You know what I mean? And I come down here. And I almost always meet somebody I can connect with. Sometimes I meet an angel. Your face looks like the face of an angel.
And you say I'm your special treat. Why? Because you love. I know you love me, girl. And we found the perfect love, girl. A love so hard to find, girl. I love you.
Humera. I know you're not talking about Stephen from political science.
I am.
Well, he doesn't even talk.
He doesn't talk to you, maybe.
Oh, please, girl. I'm not even interested. I'm just saying you had a little bit too much tequila talking about Stephen from political science at this fly. You're going to wake up tomorrow and you're going to go, Sharon was right.
Sharon was right.
Oh, no, you are not getting back on the train.
What do you want me to do, take a cab to Queens?
It is 11:30 at night on a Tuesday. I'm lending you money for a cab.
No, no, you're not. Yes, and you know what? Stop acting like my mother.
I'm not acting like your mother. Take the money. Fine. Call me when you get home.
You call me when you get home. You only have 3 blocks, but still.
All right. Do I look drunk? Huh? Do I look drunk?
No. Do I look drunk?
Yes. You do?
Yes.
Culture politics. Tomorrow.
Okay.
8:30.
Bye. Bye.
Skills, man. I got crazy, man. Stupid, ridiculous skills, kid.
Go hide your 40, man.
I got more skills than your mother got missing teeth.
Hide your 40, B.
Yeah, you see me talking to that girl at that party 5 minutes ago? She was on a nugget beat. I was kicking crazy bass to her. Man, well, I got skills, kid.
You wasn't saying nothing, man. You were corny. She was laughing at you.
I was. I was laying the construction. I was laying a framework. I was like an erector set. I was dropping fucking literature, dude. I told her like this. I said, your eyes radiate and shit.
Dude, you was like blah, 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 talking all drunk 200 miles an hour, man. She dissed you straight up, bro.
Yeah, but honey looked good, though. You got to admit.
She was all right.
She was all right. She was all right. Did you see them breastises?
I seen them shits.
That shits was like, blowing, and I was like, what, man? What, man? I got them. I seen your mom's breasts and them shits was looking rotten. Honey's be on my nugget like my name was Donald Trump. That girly at the party at the super duper rubber.
You never could have got no play talking all that bullshit. On top of that, you're ugly and that's why she dissed you.
Your shit don't even rhyme. You suck. You're the wackest. Prashant be the honey getter. What's the blackest?
Oh, why you think you're black when you know your mom's is Hindu? You never get no girls, so stop drinking and fantasizing, B.
Oh, shit. If somebody pay you, like, $100,000, you could not even fucking rhyme.
Yo, look at this girl, man.
Yo, where you from, yo? England and shit? Yo, Sweden, yo?
Yo, she looks like she could be your cousin, man. She's kind of fly, too.
Hey, yo. Watch this. Restuses.
Man, that could have been your mother.
Nah.
That could have been my mother.
That couldn't be your mother. Your mother got sagging breasts.
No, you disrespected her, man.
Man, forgive me for shit, man.
Yo, don't ask me to forgive you. Ask that girl to forgive you.
Nah, B, now you're crazy, all right?
I ain't crazy. You fucking grab some lady's breasts you don't know. You're crazy.
Okay, miss, hold it right there. Okay. Hey, stand up. Stand up and put your hands behind
what
your back.
What for?
What for?
What you...
Okay. Stay right here.
Look, there are witnesses to what happened.
You're being arrested for physical assault, okay? Turn around.
I'll get you, bitch.
Bitch, I'm not a fucking bitch.
Hey, get off me, man.
Okay,
shit.
Get right there, bitch. I'm a woman. I am a lost engineer, you crazy motherfucker.
What?
Yeah, yeah. Grab, look at my
feet. What happened?
Who the fuck?
And what happened? What did you do?
Yeah, she kicked my head.
And you know why?
Shut your mouth.
What's your name? You go to NYU?
You know Jimmy Rioni?
The whole place smells like piss. How can you stand to eating this stuff?
I'm into comfort foods.
Someone at this hospital has got to put this phone next to my mother's bed. I'm trapped in the subway. I don't have cab fare. Look, I need to speak with my mother before it's too late.
Yo, chill.
One after another, please. One. Listen, I don't want any trouble. You want something? Take it and go home.
That was a stupid magazine.
Ma, is that you? No, I wish I was there too. I'm gonna sing your favorite song for you, okay? Okay.
I don't want no trouble.
You know he had his nerve. Be done with the trouble of the world. What's that little girlfriend over there? Is she born again or something?
Crazy. Something bad just happened.
Will be done.
Daily News, 2 coffees, regular, please.
I was living in newly married comfort over on Atlantic Avenue in Brooklyn. Every day, my wife and I would step out of our apartment house together and make our way down to the A train at the Hoyt Schimmerhorn station. She would head south to her morning kindergarten class, and I would head north into Manhattan. This particular day was our 3-month anniversary. As a trader of municipal bonds, I saw this date in terms of a quarterly report. Things were better than expected.
Bernardo, now I know I told you about him before. He's the one that's always getting into trouble. Holly Calora just walks right up to him and gives this sweet little peck on the cheek. It was the funniest thing, and the whole class just busts out laughing and cheering. Anyway, it was the most adorable thing. And it was like his first kiss, you know? Mm-hmm. So sweet.
It was a chance encounter, really, which I was entirely uninvolved. So I told myself at the time, anyway. Although I couldn't help believing it was just some strange coincidence, I couldn't help hoping that it wasn't. Coincidence? Or was it fate? Whichever, our little chance encounters continued this way every day for nearly 9 months. Our relationship developed its own silent rules, strictly obeyed. Expressions of greeting and farewell were unthinkable. No word ever passed between us and no sign. Not even a shared glance or smile. But once our contact was established, it provided the means by which the rocking of the train became our own sensuous rhythm. I began to think of my hand as possessing a powerful attraction, in the way the males of certain animal species have natural adornments that females find irresistible, like the peacock's fan. At the same time, I understood what was happening between us could not be duplicated, even if I spent every available hour clutching poles in full view of all the city's females. Conversation is a risk, but I'm ready. Ready to take the next step. Oh, God. What would I possibly say to her? Share my views on Republican Party politics? What if she's a Democrat? Some comment about the weather? Too banal. I want you to love me for more than my hand. Jesus. All right. Let's spoil the mystery. We've had this thing going for a little bit of time now, you know. And I think that maybe, you know, we should have a conversation, you know. God forbid. Excuse me. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Did you hear me? Excuse me. That's out of the question? What? I'm sorry. Our first fight. I suddenly remembered Artery's territorial imperative from my psychology class in college. I understood then that I was only potent and attractive in that small area around the pole. Outside of it, the electricity would fail. What I might be losing. I guess I thought I'd found something with her that I could not find in my own marriage. But I was wrong. So I left her for the F train.
If we want to know what sex it is, you can tell us.
Yeah?
I
definitely don't want to know the sex. No, I want to do some. Come on.
Coincidence, irony, fate, what have you. Thank God, it's all behind me.
Who was that? Did you know her? Honey, who was that? Who was that?
I don't know. I don't know who that was.
back! Move back! Move back! Miss! Hey! Hey! Hey, somebody! Anybody! Don't do it! Don't jump! Please!
Pull that out! Go!